Hello, I'm Jesse with American Radon Mitigation. In this video, we are going to talk about how we addressed a house that we had to come back to. So we initially put this radon system in September, and we had kind of weak pressure field extension in some of our test holes, but our radon levels were low when we came back the next day. So I talked about it with the homeowner. I'm like, hey, we're not really reaching these areas, but the radon's low. So we left it up to the homeowner, and they're like, let's wait and see how the radon comes back. So that was about 6 months ago. We were back. They did their radon test a couple weeks ago, and down in the basement, they got 3.8, and they got 2.8 in the room above the garage. Now, these houses are a little bit unique and almost always a challenge. I've only had one that wasn't, and the fact that they have the tuck under garage. So we find a lot of times we have to get pressure field extension into the garage to lower the radon levels. And my sister's house in particular is the same exact floor plan. And I had 60 hours into my sister's house. We got a few videos of that. Here's the main one here. So if you want to check out how I struggled through that one, go ahead and take a look. But anyways, fast forward to yesterday, came back. I added 2 suction points and thought, hey, it's gonna be great. I'll come back in the morning, clean up, and we'll shoot this video. And I came back in the morning and it wasn't great. The radon was still elevated. So it took some troubleshooting, and I think we've got it licked this time. So let's go ahead and take a look and see how we came out. So my original suction point is here. We've got an 18-gallon pit here of fine sand. We are next to the plumbing that gave us the best results for pressure field extension. So the pipe goes from my pit up over towards the center of the house and then up through a chase where our fan is in the attic. We've got an RN2. It was running 1.7 inches, moving 12 CFM back in September. All right, now I'll show you the places that I did not have pressure field extension back in September. So here in the garage, I had it in the back right corner. The front right corner of the garage, I did not have pressure field extension, but again, the radon levels were low back in September. Also, back in the bathroom over here, they have a sump. And I don't know if this is original to the house or something they just added, but there's no drain tile. It's just a sump basket with some holes drilled into it to allow water to weep in there. So this sump was also my only other positive test hole. So yesterday when I came here, I thought, hey, it's simple. I'll just make those 2 test holes negative. And it wasn't quite so simple. So we'll talk about what we did next. So yesterday I started with a suction point on the sump. There's just not a good spot to core a hole here. So I added sump suction. I drilled a hole in the sump and created a small pit there. It's about 3 gallons. So my pipe runs up and over. They can soffit this in and ties into the rest of my radon system. So this is suction point 2. Let's go see suction point 3. And we tie in the mechanical room, which is right over here. So I cut in this T here. This goes to suction point 2 to the bathroom. And then here runs up and over the ceiling out to the area under the entryway. And then one thing to mention too is when I was here, I had access to maybe this much wall, and there was wall. You know, this is all up, and I could see that the wall was bowed and all the bed joints were opened up. So they did some more work here and found the whole foundation was bowed in pretty bad. So they had some of this carbon fiber stuff added on this whole back wall of the house. So they did a lot more demo, which was great because I had more access to seal stuff. So let's go take a look at the third suction point, which again is under the entryway here. It's a little bit dark in here, but pipe runs over the ceiling and then drops down. The third suction point is the one in the floor there on the right. And that's as far as I got last night. So my third suction point, I've got 13 gallons of fine sand, and I got block on both sides. You'd normally expect to find footings, but the footings are really deep there because we're close to grade near that front step. That's as far as I got last night, and I Again, I came back this morning expecting to just have to clean up, maybe shoot this video, but I've got the four eco trackers spread throughout the house, and they weren't as low as I hoped they would be. In fact, they were a lot higher than I thought they would be. We had like a five under that area where the suction point three is, and then the bathroom and this front corner of the house were right around three, and the garage was, I think, around 1.5 overnight. So I'd expected it to be a lot lower, so I worked on doing some more sealing. I did find that the tops of the block were open, and when I apply suction to that suction point two on the sump, we do leak at the top of the block. So we spent the morning sealing the block tops and everything else that we could get at, the breaks in the wall. And then we had our eco trackers out, and that room was still the highest at five under the entryway. So we ended up adding a suction point to mitigate the front step. And when we were doing that, we stuck the eco tracker in that hole that we cored through the block to get to the space under the front step. And that quickly rose to 12. Let's take a closer look at how we go about adding a suction point to treat the front step. First, I'll use my knee pad to trace where I want to remove the foam board insulation. Next, I'll use my Sawzall to cut and remove the foam board. And once I have access to the block behind, I can do layout so that my 5-inch hole lands on the core rather than going through the web of the block. Next, I'll drill a small hole that will receive the pilot bit for my 5-inch core drill. Now that I have the hole cored, I can excavate a suction point. With the pit excavated, I place an eco tracker inside the pit to see what the radon levels are under the front step. I also puff smoke into the front step, and you'll see that smoke comes back towards me. This is a good indicator that shows what's happening to the radon that is trapped under the front step and is being drawn into the house, and is likely why this room is testing at 5 picocuries. Now it's time to run pipe. I start by cutting a 13-inch piece of 4-inch PVC and gluing that to a 2-to-4 reducer. I also want to be careful to seal that pipe in the wall so that it's drawing from the suction point rather than the block wall cavity. And we use Great Stuff foam to seal the inside of the block, and we'll use radon sealant to seal the outside. Now it's time to put that foam insulation back, and we are going to cut a 5-inch hole through it that will allow that pipe penetration to pass through it. Once we put it back in place, we're going to use aluminum foil tape to tape it back in place. While I was doing all this mock-up, I kept the eco tracker in front of the pipe, and we can see that the radon levels were about 12. So this is showing that front step was definitely contributing to the elevated radon in this home. Next, it's time to glue everything together and tie it into the rest of the system. We want to make sure that we use the valve there so that we can balance the system and control how much air we pull from that front step area. And that's how you go about mitigating a front step. So once we applied suction there, we've noticed the radon levels start to drop, and everything is, I think, around 2 or slightly below 2 right now. So hopefully that continues to keep falling. But this is just a challenging one that we had to come back to. A lot of head scratching. Second time I've had to mitigate the front step in 9 years. The first time was last year. So I hope you found the video helpful. If you did, please consider subscribing or giving it a thumbs up. If you are a homeowner that has a radon system, or maybe you want to DIY it, or maybe it's just not working as good as you'd like it to, we do offer consulting. So if you're outside of our service area, feel free to reach out to us. We'll put links to a lot of the products that we use in the description below. And until next time, I'm Jesse with American Radon Mitigation. Thank you so much for watching.